Hello everyone, I'm Pranav Krishna Prasad. I'm with the Institute for Artificial Intelligence, Ravensburg-Weingarten University, and welcome to my presentation. So I'm going to present our poster paper on grasping unknown objects using convolutional neural networks. In this paper, we've used two grasping neural networks and two implementation approaches to evaluate, compare, and enhance these neural networks for grasping. First, I'm going to start with an overview of the two neural networks. So first, we have the generative grasping CNN. And this neural network takes the depth image as an input and provides the grasp map as the output. The neural network performs a pixel-wise grasp detection to generate this grasp map. In the grasp map, each pixel is represented using four parameters: the 3D grasp pose, the grasp angle, the gripper width, and the grasp quality. So the visualization of the grasp map that is seen in the image is based on the grasp quality parameter, and the red pixels denote the grasps with highest quality and the blue pixels denote grasps with lower quality. Then we have the RCNN multi-grasp network. This network takes the RGB image as the input and generates grasp rectangles as the output. So the grasp rectangles generated are in 2D and then are projected to the 3D space for grasping. Each grasp rectangle is represented by an XY pose, grasp angle, and the dimensions of the grasp rectangle. Both the neural networks were trained on the Cornell grasping dataset, which is widely used in grasping research. Now we have the two implementation approaches. So the first approach is a simple approach. We use the object dimensions to decide a grasp type. So the grasp types are front grasp and top-down grasp. And the gripper orientation is then calculated using this desired grasp type and the grasp angle that is generated by the neural networks. In this approach, side grasps are not a possibility. Then we have the second approach. In the second approach, we've used the surface normal vector that we calculated at every grasp point on the surface of the objects. And the gripper orientation was then calculated to orient the gripper in the direction of the surface normal for grasping. This approach has added side grasp possibilities. Then we have the experiments. We performed the experiments using the Tiago robot platform created by PAL Robotics. And we performed experiments in both the simulated and the real world. And we used objects that are a subset of the objects used in the RoboCup at home 2019 German Open competition. And in total, we performed 616 experiments. And based on these, we have produced these results. In these results, we have categorized the results based on the shape of the objects. This is because the shape of the objects have a huge influence on the results of grasping. So here we can see that the cylindrical objects, cuboid objects, and spherical objects, objects that have a regular shape, perform a lot better, and the irregular objects have a poor grasping result. And first we have the first approach, which we only tested in simulation. And in this approach, we have better results for the generative grasping CNN than the RCNN multi-grasp network. Then on the right side, we have the second approach, which we performed both on the simulation and the real world. And in this approach, our results prove that the RCNN multi-grasp network finally provides better results than the generative grasping CNN. So here we can also see that the irregular objects have a lower grasping performance in approach two than in approach one. This is because of the fact that the surface normal vectors generated on irregular objects would be irregular, and thus the gripper orientation would also be irregular, which would cause failure in grasping. And then based on these results, we have formed conclusions. Overall, the RCNN multi-grasp network performs better than the generative grasping CNN network. Both networks perform better in the surface normal approach. This is due to the added capability of side grasps. And we have also concluded that combining the two approaches presented here would actually give room for improvement This is due to the fact that the first approach would be better to grasp small and irregular objects, whereas the surface normal approach would be useful to add sight grasp capabilities for regular objects. So combining these two approaches would actually improve the performance. And we also propose a future direction for research. And this direction is by combining supervised learning techniques such as these with reinforcement learning, which would provide better results for grasping. Thank you for watching this presentation. I hope you all have a nice day.